All right, this is for the squad. Biden and anyone else who says they're working for the people and care about us. Enough with the bullshit. I want to let you all know, both parties, that the people's work you've done so far is inhumanely subpar, laughable, and repugnant. Your two parties are really often indistinguishable in how you screw the people over. And the main difference is that the Republicans admit they're going to screw us over, and they keep that promise. While the Democrats pretend to be our saviors, promising real change and improvements, and then screw us over. Bottom line is you both suck. You can do better. You can be better. For a long time I've heard that this is the greatest country, the richest country, the best country, from right and left. Although there is no more true left left in this country. Well, if we're so rich and great, then why can't we afford to pay our people a living wage? We're only asking for $15, which is pathetic. It should be $23. Or why can't we provide them with universal health care like other much poorer nations do for their people? I mean, seriously, why can't we do that? We're so rich and we're so great. We sure can buy bombs and spend billions of dollars on those bombs and sell them to IDF to bomb Palestinian children. What is that? Oh, and thanks, because now we can all sleep peacefully now that we know we're safe from those kids and their parents who are living in horrific apartheid conditions. Yes, thank you for protecting us from them. What you're saying to us, basically, is that we don't need a living wage or health care. All the other developed countries have that, but we don't because we're so great. What you're saying is that we need to keep paying exorbitant taxes to bomb other people trying to survive under fascism. That's what you're telling us, is that we're not worth a minimum wage that offers us dignity, that we're not worth a decent healthcare system. That's what you're telling us. You're telling us that the military-industrial complex is worth subsidizing at all costs. You're telling us that because they need another vacation island or a helicopter-capable yacht, that we need to sacrifice the things that we need. So heaven forbid that our kids need health care or a living wage. Those things will interfere with the yacht purchase or the island purchase for the military-industrial complex owners. Seriously, that's what you're telling us. Health care and a $15 minimum wage are just needs. They're not wants. We're all about wants in this country, right? That's what this is telling us, that we should be focused on what we want, not what we actually need. I mean, how is that even a thing? You know, we have to remember that you don't always get what you want. Oh, wait, you don't always get what you need. Oh, wait, how does that song go again? If you try sometimes, you get what you need or want. Wants and needs, I don't know. I'm so confused. I'm living in the USA, so we don't really understand the difference between wants and needs many times. And certainly our government doesn't. And when you live in the USA, you don't get either, especially if you aren't the 1%. But we are number one. We are number one in a lot of things. We have the highest infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate in developed nations. We also have the highest prison population in all of the world combined. Yeah, more prisoners here than in China. We have more political prisoners than any other nation. Now, that's a little secret that nobody likes to talk about. Dirty secret. We also have the largest and most expensive military in the world. It's larger than all the other nations' militaries combined. Why? Who are we so scared of? Palestinian children? The children in Afghanistan? Those girls who were blown up the other day? What are we so scared of? maybe we're scared because, well, we're not scared. The military-industrial complex is scared because they need those little islands to hide because they've been so evil. They need to hide away. Who pays for all of that? Who pays for your island and for the bombs and for all those lost lives? The people pay for that with our taxes every day. We, the people, pay to fund these endless wars around the world. But these are not even wars. A war requires two armies to fight. And these are invasions and they're acts of conquest. I mean, the IDF admitted it's just trying to do terrorism. It just wants to terrorize people. Terrorizing small children and turning them into freedom fighters seems to be the goal. And these freedom fighters end up being called insurgents. They're just trying to protect their own homes. How can you be an insurgent in your own country? How can you be an insurgent in your own house? So we can choose to continue to wage terror with the world, sending $80 billion to Israel to bomb children. Or we can choose to be at peace and have health care and living wage for our young people. If we want peace at home and health care and living wages, we should defund the military. Along with the police, who have been proven to be racist as fuck and known by the FBI for a long time, like decades, to have been deliberately infiltrated by white supremacist organizations, deliberately with the sole directive of killing black people. They have qualified immunity. They can get away with it. We could spend that money on constructive and peaceful projects like other countries get to. You know, why do other poorer countries have universal health care? Why do other poorer, much poorer countries actually pay their people a living wage? I mean, seriously, why can't we do that? Why can't we have universal health care? Why can't we house the homeless? Why can't we have a $23 minimum wage, which would actually be the correct and appropriate minimum wage, accounting for inflation? I mean, seriously, it doesn't make any sense. Why can't we have a free community college, free birth control and abortions? Why can't we legalize weed across the country? Federally legalized weed. Enough of this states' rights baloney. Why can't we end the for-profit private prison complex industry? That is horrific. Why can't we end the Electoral College, which we all know is bogus? And why can't we have automatic voter registration at the age of 18? Why is that a big deal? And make Election Day a national holiday so that the workers can actually go vote instead of just the retirees, because they want to keep the status quo. I'm going to say that again. Why can't we have Election Day be a national holiday? That will solve a lot of problems right there. Think about it. As we go extinct, and we are, because habitat, maybe our priorities should change. Should actually be about caring for each other and about each other, rather than subsidizing sociopaths and their war machines. Enough of this socialism for the rich and rugged pull yourself up by your bootstraps for the rest of us poor schmucks. We are never going to be a great nation. There is way too much blood in our history for that. But we could try to be an okay, you know, a kind of sort of okay nation. I mean, maybe we could try that for a change. Actually take care of each other instead of constantly fighting against each other. And the people don't actually want to fight with each other. That's coming down from the top. That's you guys, the squad, the Republicans, the Democrats, the fake liberals, the fake progressives, pitting us all against each other. Enough of this bullshit. Shame on every member of this current government for not actually working towards that. towards actually helping the people. You're all culpable and you're all despicable.